Hello guys, today you will learn the 10th rule of the topic when to use capital letters in English. And the rule says: the names of planets, stars, comets, galaxies, like all the other space and astronomical objects, begin with capital letters. For example, planet, Saturn, star, Polaris. It is also called the North Star or the Pole Star. Comet, Comet Halley. Galaxy, the Milky Way. Look, here you can see some other examples. Planets: Earth, Mercury. Stars: Sirius, Rigel. Comets: Hale-Bopp, Encke. Galaxies: the Andromeda Galaxy. Let's play a game now and find out if you remember the names of the planets in our solar system. You can see here a list of names, and your task will be to divide them into planets and galaxies. Okay, time's up! Some of the planets that orbit in the solar system are Mercury, Earth, Mars, Uranus. And consequently, the names of galaxies are the Andromeda Galaxy, the Cartwheel Galaxy, the Cigar Galaxy, the Sunflower Galaxy. Great! Now it's time to practice our rule a little bit. You will see some phrases now, and your task will be to make sentences. Be careful, some of the words must be capitalized. For example, 8 planets in the solar system there are. The correct order of the phrases is: there are 8 planets in the solar system. The words there and solar system must be capitalized, because there is the first word of the sentence and solar system is the name of the star system. Good, now it's your turn. The North Pole sits almost directly the North Star above. The North Star sits almost directly above the North Pole. The solar system is the galaxy, the Milky Way, that contains. The Milky Way is the galaxy that contains the solar system. Every 75-76 years, a short-period comet, Comet Halley, visible from Earth. Comet Halley is a short-period comet visible from Earth every 75-76 years. At the center of the Sun, the solar system, is the star. The Sun is the star at the center of the solar system. Of Earth, natural satellite, is the only the Moon. The Moon is the only natural satellite of Earth. And there is one more thing I'd like you to learn today. An idiom, once in a blue moon. It means very rarely, not very often. The origin of this idiom is explained by a fairly infrequent phenomenon, blue moon. For example, my brother works in England and he visits home once in a blue moon, every couple of years. You will see now some extracts from movies and TV series where this idiom is used.
Once in a blue moon.
Every once in a blue moon. Just once in a blue moon.
Such a thing happens once in a blue moon.
This is a once in a blue moon type of situation, I'd say.
And he said that only once in a blue moon does a dog's ear grow back.
I think the technical term is once in a blue moon.
And as your homework, I suggest to make up your own sentences with this idiom. Share your examples in the comments below. Tell me what you do once in a blue moon. That is all for today. Don't forget to subscribe, press the bell icon and share my today's lesson. Thank you guys for being with me today. I hope you liked my video. If yes, give me the thumbs up. I really appreciate this. I recommend to watch some of my other lessons and come back occasionally to refresh your knowledge. Stay healthy, be safe and positive. Everything will be just great. Take care.